In 2004, The American Astronaut, which is a film I directed and wrote and directed, played in a festival in Belgium, and a woman from Belgium who worked at the festival came to Brooklyn to interview me, and she said that this was right after we had the Bush administration had bombed Iraq, and she said that right now Europeans are very angry at America because of what your government is doing, and but Europeans have always really enjoyed liking American culture, and that the American Astronauts had all of the things that Europeans enjoyed liking about America. So I didn't know what that meant at the time, but I went I started touring a lot with my band and touring the world, and got to understand that, and got to understand American culture as to where before I was viewing it in a bubble. And so I wanted to do something that would address that. And so I wrote Stingray Sam, and the idea is that Stingray Sam is meant to, when I was writing it, I wanted to write something that would embrace American culture, but at the same time criticize it. And so I chose things that were American-born genres, like musicals and westerns and singing cowboys and science fiction serials, and put them in an environment that was our environment, like privatized prison systems that capitalize on their prisoners, and pharmaceutical companies, and depletion of the natural resources, and advertisers, and tobacco companies, all these things, and take those things and make a science fiction landscape out of it. It wasn't meant to be propaganda. It was actually meant to be enjoyable, but to make a landscape that basically in the same tradition as like the Twilight Zone, which a lot of the stories were inspired by the Cold War. So I took those things and made them the landscape, and took all of the things that were American genres and put them together to make this a very fun new story and science fiction musical space western, and make them in a format that would match a lot of the new technologies, as well as, but at the same time not be dependent on the technologies, because it's a film, it could be shown anywhere. Another thing too, which it was part of the inspiration, was when I was a kid, everybody talked about space travel, and they talked about living in space and the future. Everybody talked about the future, and so now people don't talk about the future anymore. And so I wanted to make a science fiction that was very naive and positive and fun, and embrace the spirit of things that I used to know when I was a kid. Yeah, well, I think it's also an attitude. Like I say, when I was a kid, the idea of space and the future. Cat in the Hat books had books saying you will live on the moon, and David Bowie was doing Ziggy Stardust, and everybody talked about flying cars and pills that you would take for incomplete meals, and then everything just kind of stopped. And so I thought it would be nice with these new advances to embrace them with the same optimistic energy that I grew up knowing. Yeah, people have been enjoying it, and I hope that Stingray Sam finds its audience and finds people who will enjoy it. It's only screening in film festivals. We're gonna distribute it at some point, hopefully theatrically, definitely on mobile phones and on DVD. They can see a trailer at stingraysam.com. Stingraysam.com. See that? And put a .com. There you go. Yeah.